Yo, turn the Rock and Rod television. Hurry.
The new book that's shocking the country. After 20 years, Shaggy of Scooby-Doo speaks out, disclosing the behind-the-scenes antics that could bring down the whole cartoon industry. Like I tell you, like we weren't just solving mysteries in that mystery van, right, Scoob? Like we used to have a bumper sticker on the back that said, "When this van's a-rockin', don't come a-knockin'." Like I gotta tell you, Velma and Daphne, Lesbian City, Carpet Munchers, Belly Rubbin', yep, I know it's hard to believe, Scrappy-Doo, like the only reason like he got his job, he was pimping for Daphne. Like, how about Fred? Like, how many guys do you know that wear a yellow scarf?
Okay.
Like, that's right. Scooby and I used to sit in the front of the mystery van and, like, do bong hits and, like, watch Velma and Daphne get it on. Like, why do you think we ate so much? It's the new book, Scrooby Dooby Doo.
Like, we would have got away with it had it not been for those damn kids.
On bookshelves across the country everywhere.
What's up? This is Rock and Rod for Rock and Rod Television. And I ordered some special fruit. Some tomatoes got magic powers. These powers are crazy. It was someplace in India. I sent over these fabulous tomatoes. Well, they look like tomatoes, but they got magical powers. Each tomato has two flavors. It's the front and the back. So I ordered them. Now look, oh, succulent, blueberry. If you turn it around, peach. Can you imagine that? Two flavors. Let me check this out. Banana. Hold up. Pineapple. Look, it even has instructions. This thing says it has a flavor. What? twat? This one is twat? I didn't know twat had a flavor. I'm gonna try it. Twat! What the? What? Tastes like shit! It tastes like pure crap! Like doo-doo! Wait! Turn it around! Now that's magic! Now that's magic! Rock and Roll Television. Magic Fruit. One. Wrong side. God damn it, I did it again.
Come in. Who is it?
Watermelon.
I didn't order no watermelon.
Avon.
I don't order no Avon. What the hell?
What are you, some kind of land shark or something?
Census.
It's every 10 years.
Beat it, bruh.
Pizza.
Why you didn't say that the first place, man? God. Come on in, bruh.
What the heck? Anybody? Order some pizza grand? Pizza grand, pizza grand, pizza grand, pizza grand. Anybody order pizza grand, pizza grand, pizza grand? Anybody order pizza grand, pizza grand, pizza grand? Does anybody order pizza grand, pizza grand, pizza grand? Pizza, 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 pizza grand, pizza, pizza grand, pizza, pizza, pizza. Pizza, 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 pizza.
I, Botar, will stand here to destroy and kill. Swag. So if you guys running around with your pants down to the ankle and you're sagging, I see your butt crack, I'll kill you. I was sent here from God of above. Not my God, not your God. Just a God. I ain't gonna say his name, but appreciate his work. Starts today. If I catch you with your pants sagging, I see an ass crack. You might die that day. Your body might not die, but you're gonna die of humiliation. Cause I'm gonna run behind you and slap you in the back of your head till you put your pants up. Listen to me. I might slap you with these nasty hands. I might pull your pants up. I might even zap you with my magic powers and make you think straight. So, heed the warning. Heed Botar, the Black Reaper of Pantsacking. So, keep wearing your pants like that and see what happens. Keep doing it. These nasty hands is gonna get you.
Who's... Baby. ¿De quién era ese colón que estaba en la cama? Ajá. El proof. What? That shit ain't mine. What you mean? ¿De qué diablo tú estás hablando? Bitch, you lucky it smells good. I'ma keep it, but just listen to me. Make sure that this don't ever, nunca en la vida, pase otra vez. Oíte, que yo no quiero llegar a la casa. Listen. I'm not no cabrón, oíte. Yo no soy ningún cabrón de nada clase, oíte. You're gonna, I'm gonna keep it. I'm gonna keep it. Just make sure it don't happen again, right? All right. Just make sure that shit don't happen again. All right. Of course. What's up, man? Hey, my way. Como está todo?
Crazy right now, man. I just wanted to do some bullshit with my girl. Spongled with fucking underwear that's not even mine.
Underwear that's not yours? I'm finding cologne on my bed that's not even mine, you. It smells good, but I gotta keep it.
Motherfucker, the underwear don't fit me. What are you talking about?
Have you tried it on?
I thought it was mine, that's why I said
it. Baby, this is what you gotta do. You gotta put it on. You gotta try it on, man. Hey, even though it ain't yours, try it on. Keep it. Right?
I can't keep it.
You gotta keep it.
Said something in my head. I told me that this girl is having somebody over.
You think she's having somebody over the house? I think my girl's having somebody in the house.
Hey.
Big ass bottle of cologne, that ain't mine.
What up, baby?
How's everything going? Everything good? Yeah?
What's going on,
bro? Nothing, man. I'm finding colognes on the bed that ain't even mine. Bitch, think I'm a cabron? I'm stupid or something?
I'm finding underwear,
bro. You find underwear in his house, I'm finding cologne in my house.
You find cologne that wasn't touched in your house.
On the bed, just laying there.
You found drawers in your house that wasn't touched.
Specifically underwear.
Yeah, bro. Yo no soy ningún cabrón de ninguna clase, oíste. Yo rapo mujeres todos los días, pero no soy un cabrón.
Ustedes son los... I'm gonna find out who's going to keep that shit.
But I'm gonna find out who's this. You feel me?
Wait, is it a fruit?
Yeah,
it was a fruit.
I just lost a fruit. What? What are you talking about? You just lost a fruit.
I think that's my cue, guys. I'll be right back.
Motherfucker!
What a comeback!
Y la besaré, aunque pelee con cualquiera.
I was walking down 8th Ave in the city, and this DJ picked me up, put me in his car, paid me for some services that he did not receive.
Oh my god. 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 Oh my god.
No. To Rock and Rod Instructional School of Black Karate. My name is Wall Wong. I was adopted by a black, half Asian family. A black father, soul brother number one, knew how to fight. My Asian mother couldn't fight a lick. So, she put me in the school for Chinese art so I could develop a cross between black and Chinese. So, I grew older, became some money, so I opened up a school for black Chinese karate school. Now, this school consists of not being able to destroy and beat your opponent, but know how to take an ass whipping from your opponent so they leave you alone and you have to worry about them again. First, always look the opponent in the eye and let them know that you whip my ass today and you whip my ass tomorrow and you whip my ass the day after and so on and so forth. But you're not going to whip my soul. So all you bullies out there and you're watching this, you're not going to win souls. You might take milk money, you might take their sneakers and their pride, but you won't take their soul if they come to my school of the Rock and Rod Instructional Chinese Black Soul Power School. First, we're going to start with the nunchucks. Are you ready? Nunchucks are very, very unique, and if you use the nunchucks the right way, you can do a lot of work. Just say you're walking down the street, la 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 la, and you're snacking on a snack. Got a new pair of sneakers on, Nikes, and a bullet chops out of the grass and go, give me your Nikes. You drop the snack on the floor and you pull out these nunchucks. Now, if used correctly, you can destroy your opponent and walk away with your Nikes. No problem. If you lose them all, this can happen. You're not getting my Nikes. No, you're not. Take these Nikes. So, you could either do two things. You can act like you're a fool, give them the sneakers, and then going about this business and probably leave you alone. Or, you can continue with the nunchucks, switch them back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, and give me your wallet. So that I get the sneakers and your wallet. But if you continue my school, I teach you how to really get big with these nunchucks. Able to maneuver and put his eyes out. So you do that, and you give him the nunchucks, and he gets it, and he wears it, and he beat your butt. Now, you give him your pride. But, you still got your soul. So, for a small fee, in 3 months of practice at Rock and Roll Chinese Black Power Soul Power Karate School, you can choose your master in deception.
Did I do swear away?
Are you ready? Are you ready to get down with the get down with the old man Mickey?
But that's the whole cracking point, guys. And to know, once again, feel is real. I cry. I will smile. I might lay back. Tell me what would I do if I could be free?
Yo, son. Check this out, son. Yo, you bring over those mollies? Yo, I can almost guarantee you, bruh, all day long, man, we're gonna get high. We're gonna get some underage girls. Hopefully get some girls when they 14, 15. Might get lucky and get a 16-year-old. So all we gotta do is just pop those mollies in them drinks. Them stupid girls don't even know what's going on, man. You just pass them a drink and they drink it. Stupid girls. They're so stupid. All I gotta do is just pop that molly and they drink and they mine. Can't believe these girls are so stupid. They do anything. They do whatever these rappers are telling them to do, they doing it. Stupid. I wish one of my four daughters would go up there and do something stupid like that. Are you crazy? Son? Are you hearing me, son? Bring those mollies. We're going to put it in these girls' drinks. We're going to have our way with them. And they ain't going to remember nothing. Because that's what's in those mollies. I don't know what's in those mollies. I'm just doing it because that's what it said on a rap song. Because it's cool. You know how many little girls are losing their virginities and their bodies and their temples on some stupid ass pill? Yo, make sure you bring enough mollies because I want to get all of those underage, stupid teenage girls. Tell you one thing. The more mollies, the more girls, the more lives we destroy. Are y'all with me? You don't think that I shouldn't go and pop these mollies and get these girls these mollies and have my way with them? If they stupid enough to take them, why not? Because if I don't give it to them, somebody else will. The parents ain't saying nothing about it. So why not? You think because I'm a proud parent and a concerned person that I want to put this out that what Molly does to teenage girls in the midst of the night with drugs and alcohol mixed? It is a date rape drug, women. It is a date rape drug. They have known cases of heroin, crack, cocaine, rat poison, and embalming fluid. And you want to take this? Well, go ahead. I'm not the devil. I'm just your average homeboy with his pants sagging, ignorant, stupid, on the corner, who don't care about your life. This is a public service announcement. Rock and Rod. This is a public service announcement. Do not take the Molly.
How you doing? This is Old Man Mickey, coming live from the United States of America. I'm a veteran of the streets. I'm the veteran of knowledge and wisdom. They call me Old Man Mickey. You see this flag here? This is the flag of the United States of America, where our forefathers, I repeat, our forefathers, blacks, whites, yellow, red, you name it, made this country. So you need to go back to feeling what you feel is right in your heart and don't judge a man by the color of his skin. It's natural to love your neighbor. It's natural. We are not beasts. We are human beings. Every last one of us. Old Man Mickey's getting mad. The United States of America, the home of the free, the land of the brave. If you racist and you go against your own in America, we call that terrorism. So, are you a terrorist? Ask yourself that question. Those who oppose and go against their own American citizens are considered terrorists, and those deserve a can of whoop ass. Can of whoop ass, everybody who go against this country because of race and creed. You get a can of whoop-ass. Old Man Mickey has talked. I have spoken. I'm out.